We watch pro players live stream their gameplay all the time, whether it be on Twitch, YouTube, or Mixer. Okay, Ninja, we see you. This, my friends, is one of the best resources to learn from the best. Well, apart from this channel, of course. Yeah, anyways. But the problem is that sometimes we simply cannot digest all the information that comes at us so fast. Like, for real, you and I, we're normal people. I get it. You know, it's like pro players just have a knack for just working at the speed of light or something. Everything comes so easy to them, it seems, right? You simply won't be able to get all the information just like that. This is just so true when looking at the comparison with all the pros. Well, that's why we're here, as today we're gonna be taking a look at some secret tips that separates you and I from pro players. What's going on, guys? This is your guy. Come on, say it with me. Your friend, the one and only Keith Allen, here to tell you again and remind you that I am your number one fan. I believe in you guys. I'm rooting for you. It's time to step out of your comfort zone. You gotta face your fears. Stop running away from them, because you're never gonna get better in this game or in life if you do so. Make sure to connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram, because I would love to hear from you. I'm posting up vids to help inspire you to do the impossible. But before we get into all of that, if you guys are interested in getting better at Fortnite, then click the link below to go to ProGuys.com, where you can play with the best players in the entire world by just clicking a button. My goodness, what was that when I was growing up? Sign up for our membership at ProGuys, and you'll get a ton of incredible content from the best players like Benji and Mongrel. Come on now. If you want to compete in Fortnite, you have to check out ProGuys.com. Also, be sure to drop a like on this video to show your support. We strive to bring you guys the best content available. All right, with that being said, it's time to sit back, relax, and get my favorite candy. What is it? It's that Bunch of Crunch, you already know. And let's start the video. Jumping into things right now, we first need to discuss, first and foremost, the foresight that pro players have that we all wish for. Yes, guys, I'm talking about thinking ahead and knowing what your next moves is going to be. I mean this both in a micro and a macro sense, whether you are in a secluded fight or planning your entire in-game rotation. Regardless of what your next immediate steps are, the fact of the matter is this. They are probably thinking about this way before they actually execute it. This is where we differ. Can we be honest here? Yes, we just think like 1 second ahead. We're just living in the moment, having fun. And most of us find ourselves going with the flow. Yeah, let's just see where it takes us. At least in some situations, until something happens. One aspect, knowing the terrain that zones go over, is super important when planning ahead. Say you know that the zone will eventually pass over a steep hill that you happen to be at the bottom of. Create scenarios in advance regarding how you plan to get over this thing without taking a pachillion zone damage. No, I didn't say a million. I didn't say a billion. I said pachillion. That's a lot. I made it up. Whatever. Scale the hill early, pressure a kid to use his mobility early, pop a few impulses. I just spotted off multiple plants in 5 seconds, all right? It's a lot going on. You can surely do the same. Even down to the basics, knowing your inventory is one example of many. You have enough mats to go for and maintain height, do you? If so, then it's an option on the table. It doesn't mean you necessarily have to do it, but you can think about it, waiting for the right time to strike. No need to only use this advice during the end game. Learn to use mobility items as a crutch during your mid-game engagement. If you have shockwaves and launch pads, then you can play more aggressive, knowing that a rotation item can bail you out at any time. But this all goes back to the original point of becoming a master planner and checking what you have to work with. How can you adapt your individual games to different situations if your head isn't in the game and processing everything that comes in your screen to the fullest? I can literally spew off over 100 more situations where using your brain to frequently remind yourself of possible options would be very beneficial to you. You probably already use a basic version of forethought, I get it, such as the latter examples that I mentioned, but our goal, ladies and gentlemen, is to have you expand that into a matured mindset when it comes to the game of Fortnite and apply it to diverse situations that require a sophisticated battle royale scholar to take the wheel. Yes, you can do it. Conveniently, thinking ahead ties directly into our next tip. I'm talking about something that we've talked about a lot, and that is reaction time. Everyone say slow motion. That's how some of us act when we play. The reason why reaction time is so intertwined with our previous tip is because when thinking ahead, you are inadvertently preparing your brain for upcoming fights. Additionally, you're creating backup plans for unexpected people you're gonna need to fight. If you've ever watched consistently Zexrow or like a young speed guy like Clix, both of these guys have taken these steps to the next level. Using these methods in combination with their already quick reaction times and abilities to read situations like no other makes them for a lethal, like seriously entertaining viewing experience. And it really does make sense if you think about it, because actively thinking ahead will always keep you alert and never on just autopilot mode. I know that when I'm not like actively thinking about my Fortnite game, it's like my brain begins to doze off and I could just see myself in Hawaii just on a surfboard. It's weird because I don't even surf. So that's how far my mind goes. And it just leaves you and I susceptible to players that just come out of nowhere. The problem is, my friends, is that players don't just pop out of nowhere. No, they don't. When they surprise you, mm-mm. Typically, you weren't just paying enough attention to the situation around you. You were probably thinking about the girl again that you should have talked to, and you didn't. Again. What's wrong with you, man? Just talk to her. Come on. Stop being shy. Constantly engaging with that new information, think about sound of shots, builds being broken, next zone locations, launch pads being placed, and everything else you can imagine. That's what's going to keep you in the game. Now, if you take this advice and someone still pops out of nowhere, I'm sorry, I'm not playing. Well, if you developed a mature enough forethought to know how to get out of a bad situation, this shouldn't be a problem either. TLDR, less just playing around in your box and more thinking about your future moves. It'll come in handy. Okay, great. Now you're developing better awareness of the situations at hand and are able to respond quicker as a result. I'm so proud of you. I really am. Keep going. Let's shift gears and discuss one universal point that pros follow in tandem with the previous tips. Don't overextend yourself. Please don't. What I mean by this is that, specifically in the endgame, the best of the best know when they need to make a move or when they can just chill. Like in my experience, I know lots of non-pro players get so jittery in the endgame. Once they get into a good position, they got everything going for them, it's just in their instincts to just mess it all up. I've been there. Like my mama said, if it ain't broke, then don't fix it. Well, to be honest with you, she's never said that. But maybe she should. It's a good line. I like that. So while we're honing in on the endgame specifically, there are two main situations that come to my mind. The first one is when you're in a tunnel, extending yourself closer to the front of the safe zone. You finally get to the front of the safe zone, right? And just sit there until your back is up against the zone and have to do the entire process all over again. Don't get me wrong, my friends. I've done this in the past a million times and continue making the same mistakes. Sometimes I just want to go for picks on the people behind me, but I get carried away from the main goal of getting so far ahead of the zone as humanly possible. The next situation that arises is when you just finish your crank battle against a stubborn opponent for height. This one really grinds my gears, guys, like really. Because when you finally secure high ground, the goal should be to keep it. I watch so many people make the same mistakes over again, and I understand, because I used to do the same thing as well. I get it. Of finally getting height and still going full aggro on opponents. Like, bro, you already have the high ground and are in practically the safest position in the entire lobby. Like, at this point, everybody wishes they could beat you. Why would you even give that up? Or at least open yourself up to someone else stealing it from you. Sometimes when you're on height, you might as well just chill, you know, like read a book. All right, maybe not read a book, but you know what I mean. Just relax. Nothing's going on. Let the opponents kill each other and just take all the free points to the bank. Let's take a look at Booga's solo cash cup game, which literally follows this advice to a T. Mm-hmm. Yes, watch this. This clip, as I talk over it, and you're going to see my point very quickly here, Booga secures the high ground and is basically pestering kids here and there with the tactical SMG spray, but doesn't over leverage himself ever. He's so chill that you could practically use this guy as an ice cooler. That's funny, right? I just made that up. You can laugh a little bit more. Yes, thank you. Be polite. But seriously, watch closely as he creates a lot of dead time where he's just reloading and waiting. He even talks to chat, saying how he is waiting for top 5. Wow. What did I say about free points again? Do you remember that? It's true. Sometimes when you're in a position that is so good, you feel inclined to just mess it up. Instead, let your opponents eat each other up while you're just playing it cool and methodical. Applying these small yet effective tips in your endgame is going to build a really solid foundation for consistency. And consistency, my friends, is key here. In fact, you know what? I got an idea. Great idea. Let's just talk about consistency a little more in depth. You want to? All right, cool. I knew you said yes. Specifically, I want to address this as my final point towards achieving consistency. And this is your mindset. I know this is probably going to be the hardest ask that I can request from you guys, but it probably would reap the most long-term impact. Okay, so I want you to remember this. If you want to get better at something, you need to critically analyze any and all of your mistakes. This is a basic fact of learning new skills in life, and in Fortnite, hey, it's not any different. I don't even want to calculate how many times a pro player became tilted only one or two games into a tournament, which spiraled into an entire gaming session gone sour. Whew, you've seen it, I've seen it. We've been there. As a third-party spectator, it's easy to see why getting discouraged in this spot is never a good thing, but much harder to apply in reality. So just to encourage you guys, just cool down, put your head down, and play the game to learn. Instead of getting all fired up and getting a fit of rage when you die and wanting to break things and go crazy, like I've done many times and I've broken many, many, many things, ask yourself what you did wrong and how you can improve. A great way to develop your mindset and better habits would be to treat Fortnite like a puzzle. You know what I mean? Like you want to solve it. Instead of getting discouraged that you died in an unfortunate situation because it happens to the best, use the misfortune to your advantage. Learn for the next time and turn that anger into fuel to make you fired up to keep going. You know what I mean? You got to do that. In fact, many pro players, both in and outside of Fortnite, use mental coaches to assist their process. The fact that pros pay other coaches to tell them this type of information should be a sign that you should take notes. Also, my PayPal is in the description underneath. No, I'm playing. You don't have to pay me. I was kidding, of course, but that would be amazing. All right, so let's go over everything one more time. First, you're going to want to think ahead of the competition when it comes to future decisions. Create multiple scenarios in your brain based on different outcomes. This will all work in tandem to prepare you for inevitably surprising and tough spots that your opponents will put you in. Since you are more prepared than ever, your reaction times in a situation will flourish. Once that's under your belt, it's time to chill out when you're in a favorable situation during the end game. You should rarely be making crazy plays every single second of the game. I mean, calm down. Even if it might seem that way, relax. In fact, taking a step back and allowing your opponents to fight each other while you just rack up guaranteed placement points will allow you to become much more consistent. Adding this consistency, working on developing better composure, and treating Fortnite scrims and learning this as a tool is going to benefit you the best. Put all of these key pillars together and you'll surely be on track to give pro players a run for their money. Once again, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. This is your guy. Come on, say it with me. Your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I want you guys to do things that you've never done before. Like I said before, face your fears. Step out of your comfort zone. Try something new. Apply these skills not only in this game, but in your life. Connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram. I want to inspire you to do some great stuff. If you enjoyed this video, we really want to ask you another thing, and that is to leave a big old like, saying that you know you appreciate us, and it shows us that you watched this until the end, and you're supporting the content that we're making. If you're not subscribed already, then you already know what to do. Apart from that, we'll see you on the next one.